Hey guys, welcome to this FegoFit workout. My name is Chelsea, and if you haven't guessed yet, we're gonna be doing some yoga. This yoga workout is great for some stretching. It's a very beginner style workout, so you don't need to be advanced by any means to complete these moves. We will be moving and flowing through some vinyasa style yoga poses, so we will be elevating the heart rate a little bit, but again, getting that deep stretch, conditioning the core a little bit, and just relaxing and taking advantage of this recovery style workout. So what we're gonna do is start in an easy seated position. If that is, you know, with your legs crossed or your legs straight out in front of you, whatever works for you. But I want you guys just to close your eyes and just start to be mindful of your body and gain some awareness. Gaining some awareness in some of those areas that might need a little extra work today, some areas that need some stretching and some lengthening. And I want you to just be so grateful for getting yourself on the mat today and just to be proud of ourselves wherever we're at with our bodies. Okay, even if, you know, you're not exactly where you want to be, just be proud of yourself for getting on the mat and for getting through this workout. Okay, so I want you guys now to come onto all fours. We're gonna come into a tabletop position and we're gonna warm up our spine. So our hands are right underneath our shoulders. Knees are also about shoulder width apart. We're gonna practice a cow cat pose. We're gonna inhale, look up to the ceiling, and exhale, tuck the chin towards the chest. Inhale up and exhale. Really try to exaggerate this movement as much as possible. We're gonna go through this two more times. Inhale and exhale. Opposite stretches, we're stretching the front of the body and the back of the body. Now we'll take one more inhale and I want you to exhale, push on those toes, go into your first downward dog. If you're not familiar with downward dog, guys, this is really the meat and potatoes of vinyasa style workouts. So we're driving all of our weight back towards our heels, pushing off the heels of the palms, spreading the fingertips wide, and we're using this as a sort of a reset for our bodies. So feel free to pedal those heels out so you can get a nice dynamic calf and hamstring stretch. Make sure there's no tension in that neck. You never want to feel any strain there. So relaxing the neck and shoulders. On down, good. Spread the toes nice and wide. Now we're gonna hold this basic downward dog, push off the hands, drive the weight back towards the heels. Beautiful stretch there. All right, and then lift up on the piggy toes and let's just walk the feet all the way in towards the hands, bending the knees if needed, okay? If you're not so flexible, that's okay. That's why you're here. We're gonna hang out in this forward fold position. So feel free if you would like, just cradle your hands in the elbow, or the elbows in the hands. And we're just gonna rock side to side. Good. Shake your head no from side to side. Shake your head yes forward and backwards. We love yoga. Yes, we love you, Chelsea. FegoFit. FegoFit, so awesome. Good, and then just rock from side to side a little more. Feeling that release on the lower back, release in the posterior part of our body. Good. Make sure you keep your core tight. Never want to deactivate our core, especially in a folded stretch like this. All right, let your hand just relax down. We're gonna ragdoll up one vertebrae at a time. Head will be the last thing to reach the top. Come into a mountain pose. Your hands are just gonna come right alongside your hips. Feel free to close your eyes for a moment. Engage your core. Shoulders relaxed and pulled away from the ears. Tall in the spine, tall in the posture. Beautiful. All right, step your feet out so you're about mat width apart here. We have one or two more stretches that we're gonna do before we go into some sun salutations. So we're gonna start with a spinal rotation here. So we're warming up in all planes of motion, getting some rotation in. And just start picking up that back heel, swinging the arms, really relaxed at your sides. Nice, looking all the way over your shoulder to the back of the room. Nice relaxed stretch here. Might get some cracks in your spine, that's good. releasing some tension. One more to each side. Good. All right, let's get some lateral stretching in. So stepping your feet in so they're about shoulder width apart. You're gonna reach. We'll inhale both arms up into the air, and then we'll actually drop one hand down. Reach, reach, reach. Extend over to the side. Good. Both arms meet in the center. Inhale and exhale. Letting that opposite hand just glide down the leg. And exhale. Feel that lengthening from fingertip all the way down to the hips. Inhale and exhale. Let's do a few more. Exhale. One more to each side. Exhale. Last time here. Before letting your arms relax down, let's pistol those fingertips together, okay? And then you're gonna squeeze your glutes together as tight as possible. Now I want you to open up that airway between the chin and the chest, eyes go up towards the hands. Take your head back, 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 your first back bend of the workout. Let your head come all the way back, squeeze the glutes, opening up the front of that body. Hold it for a few more moments, striving to get back as far as you can. And release by inhaling up and swan diving all the way down to another fold. Using this as a readjusting position. Pedaling out the feet. Feeling that release in the lower back. Nice opposing stretch for what we just did. Great job, guys. All right, and then let's roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Coming into mountain pose. Ah, nice reset. All right, good. I think we're ready to start with some sun salutations. So make sure you're at the top of your mat here. All right, and this is our nice flow we're gonna be going through. So you guys can stay with me. If you feel the need to go a little bit slower, go for it. If you've done this sort of a flow time and time again, feel free to speed it up and go at your own pace, all right? We're gonna inhale, reach the arms all the way up. Eyes go towards the hands. And swan dive down to the floor. Back to our fold. Bend your knees this time so that your hands can hit the ground. We're gonna step back your right leg first. I am mirroring you guys in this workout. So your right leg, okay? It's my left leg, but it's okay. All right, feel that nice stretch for just a moment. Walk your hands to the instep of the foot. We're gonna actually take our left hand up into the air. Look up to that open palm. Keep that back knee nice and straight, squeezing the quadricep. Feel that hip stretch on the right side and a T-spine stretch in your back. Beautiful. All right, hand's gonna come down to the outside of the foot. Step it back, plank position. Rocking out that core, belly button pulled in towards the spine. We have two options here. You can stay up tall or you can always modify in this position, okay? Modified plank. All right, I'm gonna show you up top. Tuck the elbows in towards your sides, lower your chest down, and then push your body into a low cobra, or this is an upward facing dog. Nice, opening up the front of the body, looking up towards the ceiling, shoulders relaxed and away from the ears. Nice. We're gonna flip the toes, come into a downward facing dog. Good reset here. Pedal those feet out, readjust, realign when necessary. Good, and we're gonna step, walk, or jump your feet to the front of the mat. Whatever you choose, however you get there, that's fine. Reverse swan dive the hands all the way up to the ceiling. And then you're gonna circle your arms around, sit back in a chair position. Good, we're gonna always finish out our sun salutations in this pose. All right, let's go through round two. Inhale up, swan dive down. Good, bend the knees. Now we're gonna step our left leg back behind us. Good, we're gonna do the other side. Make sure we hit both sides in this lunge. Hands walk to the instep. We'll take that right hand up into the air. Feel that nice hip flexor stretch. Straighten the back knee. Nice bright open palm. Breathing into the stretch. All right, let's step it back. So we're in our plank position. Going through a little bit faster this time. Nice and smooth. If you need to drop the knees, you can always modify. Inhale, go into your upward facing dog or low cobra. And exhale, come into downward dog. All right, step walker, jump your feet to the front of the mat. Inhale, reverse swan dive. Exhale into chair. Feel my heart rate coming up, muscles are getting warm. Inhale up, third time through. Exhale down. This time, we're gonna put our hands on our shins. Inhale up, you're gonna come to a flat back. And exhale down. Step your right leg back. You're gonna stand up in a crescent lunge, working our balance. Inhale, exhale, sink nice and low. Again, nice hip flexor stretch here. Arms stay up. Take your hands back just slightly. Good. Gripping your toes onto the mat. This will help you with your balance. Take your hands now into a prayer position, okay? We're gonna add a nice twist and rotation. You're gonna take your right elbow to the outside of your left knee. Look over top of the horizon of those hands. Nice. Let's hold here for a few breaths. All right, now what we're gonna do is actually take our left hand down to the inside of that left foot, angle the right toe out towards the side here, and we're gonna take a nice side angle pose. You're gonna push that shoulder up against the knee, feeling that stretch, abs stay tight. Trying to get this right hand here perpendicular up and down to the floor. Beautiful. All right, let's take that hand back down, step the foot back. Plank position, nice vinyasa flow. Here we go, inhale and exhale. Step walker, jump to the front. Inhale, exhale into chair. One more full sun salutation. All right, we're gonna lunge it out on the other side. Inhale up, exhale down. Don't forget, we're adding flat back. Inhale up, exhale down. Step that left leg back, standing up in that crescent lunge. Inhale and exhale. Nice, and then just rock those hips back a little bit, pressing forward through that hip flexor. And prayer position. Now left elbow comes to right knee, okay? Twist. All right, and we'll take that side angle pose. Hand comes to the instep, angle the left toe out, arm comes up in the air. And again, for you advanced people, there's a bind option that you guys can take. I'm not gonna show it to you right now, but if you know what the bind is, feel free to give it a try. Feel a nice inner thigh stretch as I push this elbow and shoulder up against the knee. All right, hand's gonna come down and go ahead and step that foot back. Nice flow here. Inhale and exhale. Abs stay strong, especially in this downward dog. Step walker, jump to the front. Inhale, reverse swan dive. Exhale, we're gonna hold our chair. I know your heart rate is probably up a little bit. We went through that full final sun salutation. We're gonna work the legs just a little bit here. You guys know me all too well, right? Figo fit, we're always up for a good, intense part of this workout here. I know my legs are burning. Stay with me here. Lift up the toes slightly, show me that the weight is in your heels. We're gonna take the left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Feel free to open this up if you'd like. Still sitting back in the glutes, arm comes up perpendicular to the floor. Let's inhale, come back to the center. And exhale, twist. Right elbow comes to the outside of the left knee. Arm comes up, hold it. And inhale, center. Reach those arms out in front of you. Can you guys give me just a few more seconds? Pick up on those toes just slightly. Drop the heels down. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, mountain pose. Close your eyes. Recover your heart rate. Beautiful flow. Hang out here for just a few more seconds. We are gonna do another half sun salutation. Don't get mad at me, okay? A little more flow to go, just to get down so that we can do some deep stretching at the bottom. So let's inhale up, exhale down. Inhale halfway up for flat back, exhale down. Bend the knees, walk those feet back. All we're gonna do, drop the knees down. Child's pose, everyone's favorite pose. Oh, love that. Forehead's gonna come all the way down to the floor, sitting back in the glutes. Just feeling that nice release in the lower back, release in the hips, adjusting where you need to and trying to grab onto that mat with those fingertips so we can get that nice upper body stretch. Few breaths here. Every time we inhale, I want you to feel your lower back expanding up like a balloon and then exhaling, just deflating that balloon, every last drop of air. Take about two or three more breaths here. Very nice, guys. All right. And when you're ready, we're gonna do a nice deep stretch pose. We're gonna prop ourselves up onto the elbows here. One of my favorite shoulder stretches, it's called thread the needle. So we'll start with that right side. You're gonna inhale on up, and then you're gonna exhale, thread that right arm underneath that opposite arm. Eyes are gonna look over toward your left. And then if you would like, I'll give you guys the option. You can take that left hand onto your lower back. Just feel that deep stretch in the shoulder. Holding for a few breaths here. All right, and we'll come back out to our neutral position. And let's take this on the other side. Left arm, inhale on up, and exhale, thread the needle. Look over to your right, and then take that hand on the small of your back. Love this release in the shoulder. And come back to neutral. Very nice here, guys. All right, we're not done with downward dog quite yet, so I want you guys to take an inhale, and as you exhale, shift back into that downward facing dog. All right, take those alignment adjustments where you need to. Good, we got about 10 more minutes left in this workout, so stay with me here. We're gonna go through a little bit more flow, okay? We're gonna go through a bit of a warrior series, okay? So we're gonna vinyasa flow through this using the breath as our anchor. So I want you guys to inhale, you're gonna take your right foot up. This is called a three-legged dog, still pushing down through the left heel. And then what I want you guys to do is use some momentum. You're gonna exhale, step your foot all the way to the front of your mat. I know a lot of people have trouble doing that, so if your foot ends up here, all you gotta do, pick it up, move it forward, okay? All right, angle the left toes out towards the side here. You're gonna stand up, warrior one. Square your shoulders and your hips as much as you can to the front, sinking low in the lead leg, back leg is straight. Very nice. All right, take an inhale, and I want you guys to exhale, come into a warrior two. We are working our balance a little bit here, working this quadricep. We already feel it from that chair position. Gotta love that. Good. Now we're gonna flip our palm. I want you to reach forward and then glide that left hand down the back leg. This is called reverse warrior. Very nice. And what we're gonna do is cartwheel the hands down, framing your foot, step the foot back, plank position. You have the option, you can meet me in downward dog, or if you wanna flow through this, inhale to up dog, exhale to down dog. You can always meet here. And if you're feeling like this is a little too intense for you, you can always just relax, rest in a child's pose, and then meet up with me when you can. All right, same sequence on the other side. Inhaling the left leg up, feeling that nice stretch, three-legged dog, and then we're gonna exhale, step it all the way through, pick up the foot if necessary. Angle the toes out, standing on up, warrior one. Beautiful, strong warriors. All right, and then inhale, exhale into warrior two. Check your front and your back hand, make sure they're nice and equal, okay? Flip the palm, reach forward, and bring it on back, reverse warrior pose. All right, cartwheel the hands down to frame that foot, step it back. Vinyasa flow, here we go. All right, we're gonna go through one more time on each side. We gotta add a little balancing element to this. So inhale, the right leg comes up. You're gonna exhale, step it on through. Inhale up into warrior one. Exhale into warrior two. You're gonna inhale, reach forward. Exhale, reverse warrior. We're gonna do that a few more times, and actually when you inhale, bring that right elbow to the knee and then exhale into reverse warrior. Take your time, do this a few times here. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. We're kind of winding ourselves up here. We're gonna do a warrior three pose. All right, for those of you guys that know what that is, take it at any time. If you're staying with me, I'm going on this rep. Inhale, exhale. Now I'm gonna shift the weight to the lead leg. Come into a warrior three position. Back leg parallel to the ground. A few options with the arms. You can take them out to the sides. Reach forward. Hi guys, doing great. And then that back foot, you wanna flex the toes in towards the shin. Let's hold for about 10 more seconds here. You got this. Good challenge to your balance. And then drop that foot down. Hands come down. Vinyasa flow here. And exhale. All right, one more time on the other side. Inhale up. Exhale, step it on through. Inhale to warrior one. Exhale to warrior two. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, reverse warrior. All right, and then take it at that angle. Inhale and exhale a few times. And exhale. Knowing that we're just doing such a good thing for our body here. Way to go, guys. Keep it up. Almost finished with the workout. All right, here's my last time. Inhale and exhale. All right, finding the balance. This side is not as good as the other for me. I don't know about you. Flex the toes in towards the shin. Choose your poison with your hands to the side, out in front of you. You can always hold the ground with a yoga block if you have one. About 10 more seconds. We got it, focusing on one spot on the floor. Breathing. And step it on back. Last vinyasa flow, I swear. Here we go. Downward dog. And then let's just meet down in a child's pose. If you guys want, you want to get a nice inner thigh stretch, feel free. Take your knees out towards the side of your mat, toes come together, and sit back in those heels. Forehead comes all the way down to the mat. Just recover your body here in this position. Catch your breath. And I want you guys to try one more deep stretch here. We're gonna come into a high kneel position. I want you guys to take that right leg and you're gonna prop it out in front of you, okay? We're gonna inhale, circle the arms up. Exhale, we're gonna reach forward to that lead leg. Good. And then sit back on that heel all the way back behind you. reaching forward, wrapping your hands around the outside of that foot if you can. If not, just grab onto the mat. Try to take that forehead all the way down towards the floor. Beautiful. Flexing the toes all the way in towards the shin. All right, and let's come on out of that. Same thing on the other side. Prop that foot forward, left side. Start with an inhale and an exhale. Sinking into that stretch, sitting back towards the heels. And again, you might be a little more flexible on one side than the other side, and that's totally okay. All right, and then bring it on back. Very nice. What we're gonna do is come back into our easy seated position here, guys. You can finish out the way you started this workout, or if you would like, extend those legs out in front of you. We're gonna finish with just a final meditation here. Just relax here for about another 30 seconds. Clearing your mind from any stressors, any anxieties, any worries. Just be grateful to yourself for embracing this workout and trying something new if you're a beginner. You stretched out those muscles, we lengthened those muscles, and we are one step closer to becoming the best version of ourselves. Go ahead, bring your hands to heart center. Namaste. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day and hope you guys enjoy the rest of some of my FegoFit workouts. Let me know if you have any questions or comments and hope to see you guys again soon. Stay Fego, stay fresh, kids.